Hello, my friends. This is Wolfgang with Tools for Ascension. And today, my gift to you is this video about meeting your totem animal. Well, first, I will give you an overview about the idea of totem animal, of spirit animal and familiar, and I give you traditional references as well as some personal experiences. Then, we will go into a guided meditation where we invite your most important totem animal at this stage in your life. If you already have that one, you can go to the next one in line, or the one that will assist you in a particular issue. And do you want to prepare a list of your questions or issues, at least in your mind, before you go into a guided meditation? And in case you did not already know, I do private face-to-face Skype session at a very reasonable rate. So, according to Google, the cornucopia of human knowledge, a spirit animal is characterized as a teacher or messenger that comes in the form of an animal and has a personal relationship to an individual, you know. Other names might be animal guides, spirit helpers, spirit allies, power animals, or animal helpers. And you can have one or several spirit animals throughout your lifetime. Another reference from Google is totem animals are believed to be the animals that we feel a very strong connection with and can influence us throughout our lives. In shamanism, an animal totem is meant to be a representation of the traits and skills that you are supposed to learn, acquire, or embody, you know. And now this is my own personal comment. So with embodying, they really mean that you you know, that the spirit or overshadowing deity of, let's say, a frog or a jaguar, you know, or a deer or a buffalo, you know, enters your body. And you have a communication through this, and in magic, in old magic, caveman magic, you know, that try to, you know, influence them, you know, for better hunting. Native American would call this a giveaway, but also, you know, honor and bring in messengers, you know, from these people to their own people, you know, because their life was definitely interdependent. Personally, I see, you know, the whole idea of totem animals, I see them as an expansion of the supreme, you know, absolute source, but in a more relatable, predigested and defined form. Like plugging into our observations of nature, you know, our neighbors, right? So, let's say in advanced kung fu, you know, animal form styles of fighting, you know, being used. And, you know, if it's an advanced fighter, you know, I would also say that they will embody, you know, I mean, practically, you know, get possessed, you know, by one of those animal intelligences. And you don't want to fight a guy like that. You know, anybody that's a mystic who can do breath of fire for a long time, you know, they have an edge, whatever their skill and strength level is. Mm-hmm. So what's the difference between a totem animal and, let's say, an individual animal, let's say a bear or your pet, you know? And I find it's the same in issue like you have with humans, you know. So am I relating, you know, to, let's say, for instance, this local person, let's say Betty, right? Do I deal with her, you know, the conditioned soul, conditioned by her upbringing, her DNA, you know, astrology, etc., you know? Or am I relating, you know, to the higher aspect, you know, of this lady, let's say, you know, to like the angelic consciousness that is overshadowing her. Yes, the angelic part of her, right? And even this can be on different levels of consciousness, right? Or am I communicating, you know, with Source through these people? You know, of course, they have to be quite saintly, but not necessarily required, you know. Generally, this happens with very saintly people, that God can talk to them or through them. And, I mean, who knows what is God, but, you know, this is a personal impression you get, but, you know, God can talk through anybody, just like Mr. Smith in The Matrix can, you know, manifest through any program, just pop in there, right? So these realities are definitely there. So, yeah, you know, am I, when I'm having, you know, an animal in front of me, am I encountering, you know, a soul stream? You know, where there is a past life memory, maybe when we were hunting together, you know, it's a dog that's coming back, and with those memories, you know, or am I dealing with the overshadowing intelligence, the angelic intelligence, you know, of this being? And just to give you an idea about this, so recently, you know, with one client, you know, has one of those beautiful, what's this, northern dogs, you know, the ones that have those blue eyes and big personalities. And I hooked her up, you know, to the high self of the dog, and it was a lion. It appeared as a lion, you know. So, which, of course, you know, why does a lion, you know, why is a lion the high self of a dog? Well, obviously, you know, a lion cannot, cannot, you know, be with a family in modern culture, right? It's just not possible, unless you live in a zoo, so, you know, or in Arkansas. So, you know, it was appropriate to take the body, you know, of a dog to be a protector and a companion for this. Also, I'm just going from here to there, excuse me. But like in Native American tradition, you know, there is a lot of communication, you know, with the animal kingdom, you know, and how you communicate, you know, through, let's say, all that is. You know, in, let's say, when you're in this consciousness, you know, every animal that appears to you, you know, it can also be, you know, a tarot reading for yourself. You know the characters, you know, of the species, and, you know, even the species of herbs and trees, you know, it really depends. You know, they're all omens, they're all like tarot cards, and higher intelligences can communicate through them with you, right? I give you an example. You know, once I started a new job, and on my first trip to work, you know, a hawk just banged on my windshield. It was quite a thump, and I don't think he got hurt, but, you know, hawk means pay attention, and this has been a very, very dangerous road, and I always was hyper-vigilant at those stretches, and I probably avoided several accidents. So this would be, you know, a communication from this totem animal intelligence. And another thing about totem animals, sometimes they want you to consume some of the DNA of that species. And I'm telling you this not to encourage, you know, exotic eating. I mean, absolutely not. But, you know, I want to avoid unnecessary guilt, you know, of somebody, you know, that is offered a rattlesnake and or a turtle soup, you know, or something, you know, that they would not eat at all, right? I mean, if you're vegan or a vegetarian, you know, especially if it is a very rare species. You know, I've had personal experiences where, let's say, turtle eggs were offered to me. And this was 40 years ago. And, you know, I rejected this, you know. And, this, you know, the locals said, well, we're going to eat them if you don't want some. And so I said, okay, you know, I'm going to try some. And then many years later, about 15, 20 years later, this animal came to me and said, you know, no, I wanted you to have my DNA, you know. don't feel guilty, you know, this is, I wanted you to have this, that's how I came to you. And, yeah, so you will know, you will know. And another thing, you know, just to prepare you, you know, in communication, you know, with your totem animals. So I had, you know, a wonderful client, and she wanted to change, you know, her place of living. And so she also wanted to experience her totem animal, and so we called her totem animal, and it was a fox. And we placed this question, you know, what kind of advice do you give, you know, for moving? And the fox kind of, you know, in kind of understanding, when he didn't talk, but he showed it in images and ideas. You know, he looks, a fox is not very strong, you know, it cannot put up with dogs. So it looks for an area where there are no dogs, and where it has, you know, good cover to move everywhere, so it's not like has to cross like big empty fields where it's very exposed. And of course, where there is food, good food and other supplies. So safety was one of the first concern, right? So this, you know, give a good perspective. Right, are there burnt out Camaros in your street with bullet holes? Right, probably not a good idea to move there. And also, you know, with so many people, one of the totem animals that always comes up is a mother bear. And generally, you know, these are, you know, for protection. And I mean, what is more fierce than a mother bear? Right, so this comes up quite a lot. And I also, you know, personally, I recommend, you know, the medicine cards made from Jamie Sims and David Carson. You know, I used those a lot. And I just love the interpretation that they give on the animals and just their language. It is very uplifting, you know, to read this. You know, whenever you read a book and you feel good and uplifted, you know, this shows that there is a good consciousness behind. So I kind of recommend this, and I'm not getting any kickbacks. They probably don't know me at all. So, and before we go now into the guided meditation, I want to point up some principles that I found support the success of any guided meditation. So first of all, you know, sit comfortable in an office chair, you know, and balance your body so, you know, that you do not need any muscles to support it. But I also find it quite successful. You know, personally, I prefer this when I kind of sway slightly, you know. Always keep slightly moving. Actually, I don't mind cranking my neck or my spine. Especially when you start running Kundalini, you know, actually I recommend, you know, whenever you feel the urge to do some cranking in your spine or anywhere, you know, go ahead and do so. It will increase the energy flow. And, you know, it's part of kriyas, you know, part of purification. I also, so when you slump, it's difficult to enjoy bliss and high energy too. Also, I advise to use earbuds, or headphones. First of all, they cancel out outside noise. Plus, also, it's a deeper experience when there's a voice in your head instead of some coming through some crappy speakers. Of course, do not drive and operate heavy machinery. And smile like an idiot as much as you can during the meditation and reside in your heart. When you reside in your heart, then you are more in your intuition, where you're supposed to reside as a human. Then you're more connected to the earth realm and to the intellectual and higher, finer realms. Where when you're here, you're on the mental plane and you can just get lost there. Also the smiling, will help you to get into the love vibration, and only then really will you be able to access the or experience the higher dimensions, because they're all based on the love vibration. So no smiling, you're not gonna go far. All right? And also, especially at the beginning, breathe deeply. I mean, I know there are people that just, you barely notice that they're breathing, and they think that's really cool and advanced. And yeah, maybe. But personally, I think that's when you start this meditation, you have to kind of, breathe deeper to just cheer yourself up, to open your chakras, to clear all the pathways. I mean, when you're coming from normal waking day consciousness, in my opinion, you're clogged up, as a yogi. So, it's really, to order to get deep into the meditation, you got to breathe deeply and really, do follow this guided meditation, what I suggest. So you clear your meridians, you clear your nadis and your chakras, your energy field. If you don't even believe in those, maybe you charge up your brain, this oxygen. And so, but you want to hear the air flowing through your nostrils, so that's the standard. And also, don't breathe through your mouth, right? So, like, breathe like this. All right, see, I start giggling. The chi, it's just nice. Body starts tingling. So, you also do not have to repeat my affirmation. Just think amen, or nod your head, especially when you're, focusing on your breath, or just, align, with what I'm saying, because it's your life. And they need permission. And if you just go, ah, yeah, all right, not much is gonna happen. Plus, be in a childlike state of innocence, during the guided meditation, So just what I mean with this, just pay attention to what pops into your mind. Try not to judge it. I mean, even in private one-on-one sessions, so many times people judge what comes in, and and it's funny because it's just generally sometimes some far-out stuff, and they think it's made up because it's so far out. But in general, because I do so many guided meditations with people one-on-one, these are not necessarily far-out things. This is just, what happens and what you see sometimes. And there's an explanation for that, but then later on, just try to pick it apart. Don't judge anything that pops in this state. Just take it as brainstorming. Somebody is just babbling, and don't just shut it down. Just let it happen. Playful. Playful. That's how you, advance. Yeah? Not stiff. There is no creativity in stiffness. Also, you can use the K button at your keyboard. you know, to pause and play during the guided meditation, you know. So you can spend more time, you know, on getting an answer. Because, I mean, sometimes you may have to, you know, explore, you know, those are ones that actually get communication going, you know, fluently, and there are those. You know, you might spend some time exploring, you know, one answer. And so I suggest, you know, you just pause it, you know. Another suggestion is that, you know, if you know, okay, you get some answers and later on, you know, you want to go deeper, you know, you maybe go next time with your eyes open, just follow all the visualization and then use the pendulum. But of course, you know, invoke protection and highest good. And some of you, this might help very much. Of course, nothing is faster than having a personal session. Also, yeah, so let's get to it. Close your eyes. And first we, let's say, connect to Source. And so Source is everything, right? So everything is kind of God, part of God, right? Even our bodies, you know? So we're just completely surrounded by God. And I call this, in my personal imagery, as rest in God, you know? So I'm very small and I'm just connected with this all around me. Yeah, and let's hope, you know, God is benevolent. Otherwise, we are quite screwed, right? Yeah, so just open to that love. So this is, you know, we connect to Source or rest in God. And let's connect to your highest self. Mm-hmm. And your inner child and Mother Earth and the elements of Mother Earth and your spirit guides all the way up to Source, all the angels and other helpers, you know, rolled in. And Milky Way galaxy. And we call on also all your incarnations that are able and willing, you know, to assist you, you know, in waking up in this incarnation. Amen, 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 amen. And I ask that everything that happens in and from this session is going to be for the highest good and divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes. Amen, 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 amen. And I also ask that you're completely safe, you know, from any deception, from any implantation or transference of karma, curses, entities, cords, you know, nothing negative at all, right? Through all dimensions, subpersonalities, incarnations, and localities. Amen, 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 amen. And now, you know, smile like an idiot and, you know, imagine that you shapeshift your thighs, and your spine like big taproots into the earth, and they just take off like little puppies, completely eager to go in there and just split up into smaller and smaller puppies. Ah, yes, and Mother Earth loves you unconditionally, and she's smart. And as you're opening up through those roots to her, you know, just allow her to send her love into you. Let her love rise in you now and smile. And on the inhale, just imagine that you draw her love through those roots, just like through straws into yourself, just really deep. And then you send your love, smiling like an idiot, to her through those roots. And you go back and forth. And you ask for a clearing of any, you know, cords and devices and magic or technology that harvests your energy, steals your energy or manipulates your energy, you know, against your highest good. Now, amen. And just keep breathing and enjoy the enhanced energy flow. Yeah, that's how you know you got plugged. You know, and that's very, very common. I mean, you know. But just know you got plugged. And now put the tongue onto the palate, you know, of your roof, top of the mouth. And that will enhance the chi flow into your brain, right? And, you know, really energize your brain. So on the inhale, you still draw that love from Mother Earth into your heart. And on the exhale, you send it from your heart into the brain and, you know, work around the brain, you know, just clear the area around your head with that breath. Just keep pumping it in there. Yeah, and try to get all the way up to the ceiling. I'm talking like maybe 2 meters or 6 feet, if you can. You know, don't limit yourself. Just reach as high as you can. And we asked for your spirit guides and the angels to do a nice clearing on your crown chakra now. Amen. And just keep breathing and smile like an idiot. You know, otherwise you won't get much love. Right. And now we ask Milky Way Galaxy and the cosmos, you know, to just pour, you know, the love like the waters of life from the heavens, you know, into your crown, but also over your head, you know, through your head, through your shoulders, over your shoulders, your heart, your arms, your head. Just let it flow over your feet and out your feet, deep into the earth. And you smile like an idiot, just smile like an idiot. And you allow these waves of loving chi to cleanse you. And now we ask, that we have a clearing of our heart chakra. We have picked up so much pain from our heart, in our heart, from other people, and we still carry pain from our own life. And probably pain also from other people's heart has been sent to us. So all this carrying of pain in the heart doesn't really help anybody and is not necessary. So we asked our higher self, our spirit guides, angels included, to please clear as much pain from our heart right now as it is possible. Amen, 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 amen. Yeah. And smile like an idiot. And now focus on pulling in that love from the heaven realm through your crown chakra into your heart, as well as the supporting love from Mother Earth. You simultaneously just pull them in your heart, into your heart, and just expand it in your heart, just like your rose that opens from a bud into a beautiful fluffy rose, but just much more fluffy petals, you know, not so defined, transparent, yes. And smile like an idiot, you know, while you're just pumping this beautiful love into your heart. And now we ask for your most important totem animal to please come in front of you. Amen. And some of you, or most of you, will probably feel a presence. Some of you will see, you know, a presence or get an idea, you know, about an animal. There are different ways. And don't think you're making it up. I mean, yes, you know, if you remember that you liked a rabbit when you were a kid, well, that means it's a rabbit, right? Just be naive here. And so, first of all, like always, sorry, no offense to the totem animal, but we gotta make a test. So we put a column of violet light on it, you know, and see, you know, whether it squirms or whether it smiles. When it smiles, it's the real thing, you know, and when it squirms or gets angry and runs away, it's an imposter. And you don't want to deal with that one. Yeah? That's a shapeshifter that wanted to, you know, mess with you. All right. So let's assume, you know, the totem animal passed your test. And now you take that level that you learned how to, you know, transmute, you know, from heaven and earth into your heart. And on the exhale, you send this to this totem animal that came to you. So just keep pulling in that love from the universe into your heart and then send it to your totem animal. That's just good etiquette. And smile, 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 yes. And see, you know, if it sends love back to you, kind of like an echo. And if that feels good and safe to you, you might even, you know, pull, you know, on the inhale, or, you know, support the pulling of the love from the totem animal's heart into your heart. And on the exhale, you know, you send your love to the totem animal's heart, yes. And smile like an idiot. And, you know, we are, of course, Archangel Michael and all kinds of safety and security is in place. And let us just ask if it is appropriate that this totem animal step into your body for just a little while, you know, so you know how it feels when it is in your body. Okay, so ask first. And, you know, if you just ask, should I allow it in my body? And if you get a yes, I would take this as an upflow of energy from your heart. And if you get a downflow of energy from your heart, I would take that as a no. So, should you ask, should you allow it in your body for a little while? Yes or no? And if you got a yes, just allow it to come into your body. Otherwise, just keep running love with your totem animal. All right, it probably depends really what kind of animal it is. You know, when it's a mouse, I don't know how that would feel, but if it's like a bear, you probably feel much bigger and stronger, right? But just, you know, feel, you know, the energy, see how your energy shifts differently, how your perception shifts. And again, you know, let us, you know, ask some yes but no question. And let's see, you know, if you enjoy having this totem animal in you, you know, just go ahead. And if not, just ask it to step out of your body now. Amen. And notice the difference again as you return to your normal human energy. And again, we will ask the animal, you know, some questions, and let us establish again the protocol. A yes answer would be an upflow of energy, and a no would be a downflow of energy. So ask the totem animal to give you a yes now. I mean, it could also just say yes or nod its head. I mean, there are no limitations. This is just the basics, right? And also ask to be given a no now. All right. So, first question, you know, would this totem animal love to be more present in your life? Yes or no? And ask, you know, whether it already plays a role in your life. Yes or no? And ask maybe, you know, to give you some memories, you know, of, you know, situation when it was playing a role in your life. Mm-hmm. Now. And maybe you need some more time, just press the K button and ask it also now, in which areas of your life would it be, you know, of greatest assistance for you? Okay, and let's get a little bit more specific and ask it, you know, what, you know, particular, you know, two gifts, you know, best gifts does it bring to you? All right. And now ask, you know, does it also give you certain physical lessons? And now ask, does it give you also certain emotional lessons? And now ask, does it also give you some mental understandings? And now ask, does it also give you some spiritual lessons? Okay, and probably you came with a question prepared. And now we asked your totem animal, you know, for its help or advice regarding, you know, this particular issue, you know, or just pick any problem in your life. You know, maybe how to deal with a certain person, you know, or with a certain other issue, and ask for advice on from their perspective, you know, from the totem animal's perspective. Ask now, amen. Now let's also ask, you know, what kind of perspective of you, you know, that's different from you, does it have on your mother? All right, and how about your father? And how about, you know, if you have a sibling, just pick one, and how about that sibling? And I hope you're given some kind of answer, you know, but if, you know, you get just a few answers throughout the meditation, that could be quite some insight. So, now ask, what are you supposed to learn, you know, from your relationship, you know, with your ex-lover, you know, your Xbox? Okay, I hope you got that one. And so, what are you supposed to learn from your relationship with your present-time lover? And now just ask, you know, any advice, you know, on love in general, you know, from the totem animal's perspective. And now ask, you know, some of you are single and probably, you know, starving for, you know, a partner. So ask, you know, what will you need to do, you know, to meet your perfect match? And now, of course, there's always the money thing. So get the perspective of your totem animal regarding, you know, your property, your wealth. Yeah, and your job is, of course, you know, also always related to your wealth in general. So ask your totem animal, does it think that you are on the right career path? And just maybe to deal with some doubts, ask whether you should change your career, yes or no. And, well, maybe, you know, you lack some inspiration and ideas, so you may ask, you know, how can I have a better job situation? And now ask, you know, whether, you know, it wants to comment on your issues of safety. I mean, it depends on the neighborhood, you know, whether you're on the highway or on dark alleys, whether you're male, female, large or small. Right? Just ask. Now ask the totem animal intelligence about issues on food. What should you eat more of? And what should you eat less of or even avoid? How about changes in your preparation of food? Could you do any improvements there? And let's ask animal totem's opinion on the issues of your health. You know, is there something to change to improve your health condition? How about exercise? Any particular tips that it thinks would be really interfacing good with you? And some totem animals are really good, you know, with family affairs. So just ask, you know, about your family. You know, do you have a particular problem in your family? Just ask about that. Okay, and now ask how you can improve your home, you know, to make your relationship stronger, you know, your family life. And if you have a kid, ask how to deal with a particular problem, you know, with your kid. And if you have neighbors and some problems with them, or maybe question, you know, ask, you know, what is the common, how to deal with your neighbor. And now ask about, you know, how to deal with a particular issue in your circle of friends. And ask, what steps should you take in order to have more friends that are loyal to you? And, well, maybe ask also how to deal with a particular issue that you have with your work colleagues. Just pick one. And now ask, you know, is there any advice on how to improve your day-to-day spirituality? You know, how to make it more joyful, vital. And of course you already prepared, you know, a particular question, you know, regarding an issue. And so let's ask, you know, your totem animal, you know, where did this particular problem originate, in a past lifetime or in this lifetime? And ask to be kind of shown, you know, in principle, what happened. And you may, you know, need to spend some time just to hold the K key, you know, down to pause it. But when you got the answer, ask, so why is the issue still here in this lifetime? You know, what has to happen to let go of it, to transmute it? And also please show us the energy now, you know, where this energy from this incident is still located. Okay, and now invite your totem animal, you know, to do its thing, whatever it does. It really depends on the species, I guess. You know, to maybe help you with this issue, you know, to take this energy away and transmute it. Please do so now. Amen. And just smile and pump love. Pump love into the dark area that the totem animal showed you. Okay, and now we thank all those beings, you know, the totem animals and all the other beings that came, you know, and helped, you know, the spirit guides, source, you know, the elements. Everybody that assisted you, we thank you very much. And we ask that any portals that should be closed, and any energies that should be cleared, and any entities that kind of still stuck, you know, please be brought home, you know, into the higher dimensions where they belong. Now, amen. And I will count to three, and you will be back in waking day consciousness. One, you become aware of your body and your room, and two, you slip back into your toes, into your heels, into your fingers, and three, you adjust your spine, open your eyes, you're back in waking day consciousness. Hello my friends, I hope you had a good time. Yeah, so this is just a shotgun meditation and will probably not, you know, ascend all your stuck soul fragments, ghosts and traumas, you know, much of the time you will have to do these kind of guided meditations, you know, just like you would take pills or drink teas, right? Instant fulfillment probably would be an overload and most likely be traumatic, but I have to say, for some of you, you know, you waking up very, very rapid, so don't think you're crazy, you know, especially when weird things happen. So, no, there's a good explanation for everything. So, also, you know, the information density, you know, in this guided meditation, so it's very high. You know, even if you, like, get 10% of the questions answered, that's a lot. That's a lot to digest, right? So, because there's so much packed into this, you know, it's good to listen to the meditation several times, you know, and maybe even, you know, go over with the pendulum, you know, and investigate further, right? Especially, you know, when you get strong reactions to certain issues. Mm-hmm. And so, yeah, many lessons, you know, energies, you know, need to be looked up in greater detail, you know, before they can be released. And that is when a lesson or insight is needed before the trauma can be transmuted. You know, the insight is like the homework, you know, that you have to do. Good parents help with the homework, but they do not make the homework. So not everything can just be said, okay, spirit guide, just take this and do that. No, you gotta do some stuff too on your side. So just ask for the highest and most accessible guidance, you know, that it may come to you through books, YouTube, info, websites, people, nature, like totem animals, like animals that appear in you, or flowers, dreams, or much more. Yeah, just amen. Uh-huh. And of course, you know, you can always treat yourself to a private Skype session and cut right to the chase. My prices are very, very reasonable. Just send me an email, you know, and I will get you the information. If you respond well to the guided meditations, you know, please do the cyber life stuff to increase my ratings, you know, somehow. They do not very good for some reason. I don't know what's going on with your, you know, search engines. But, you know, subscribe, ring the bell, thumbs up, tell your friends, leave comments, and smile like an idiot. You know, enjoy, and enjoy the other videos too. You know, I love you. Namaste.